Now let's begin the chapter on springs, and we'll start by understanding the closed coil helical spring under axial load. So this is how a closed coil helical spring looks like, and it is, you know, acted upon by an axial load, right? Now, there are three terms to it, very important. First is capital D, small n. Capital D is the mean coil dia, so this is the coil. The coil dia is capital D, and that's the average. So this is mean coil diameter. Then you have small d. So this coil is wound up by a wire. So this is the wire which is creating this coil. So small d is the dia of the wire. So this is wire diameter. Okay. And then you have n, which is the number of turns of this wire to create the coil. So number of turns. Okay. Now if you look at this, when you pull this closed coiled spring like this, what happens is they are very, very closely packed, these coils are. So this wire will actually twist like a shaft. Okay. So if you look at this particular cross section over here, so this is nothing but one cut section of a coil. If you look from the top, a coil will be nothing like this. This is the coil. So when you cut it from here, when you cut it from here and you have a look over here, so this is what you're going to see. So what is happening is, when you pull it down, this cross section, this twists. So twisting is by an angle theta. So this part, it twists and it moves down. Okay, so this is the kind of twisting that is taking place in this wire. So I'll repeat, when you pull it down, this wire, it rotates or it twists by an angle theta and it moves down. So due to the twisting, there is an angle of twist theta coming into picture, and there is some linear displacement also. Okay. So from this, I can say, now this is the half of the coil dia. You can see this. This would be the half of the coil dia, right? So this x is not a very considerable quantity, although I've shown it to be a very big quantity. So this angle will also be very less. So I can say that this length is almost equal to this length. Okay, and I can find out that this x is equal to d by 2 into theta. That is, the length of the arc is equal to a radius into theta, or the angle included. All right. So now we have got this. So what happens when you pull it? So this entire coil, it kind of twists. So there's a torque being produced. So that torque that is being produced is load into mean coil dia into 2. Mean coil dia into 2. From here I can find out theta. So theta will be equal to 2x upon d. Okay. So let's move forward. Let's now apply the shear torsion equation, because we are considering pure shearing. So you'll have T upon J is equal to tau upon R is equal to G theta upon L. Now L is nothing but the coil length, and that will be equal to pi into capital D into N, that is pi dN. Okay, so T I know is W into D by 2, J of the wire, we'll find out the polar moment of inertia of the wire, so it will be pi upon 32 into D to the power 4, this becomes 2 tau upon D is equal to G. Now what is theta? Theta I've already found out, this, 2x upon D upon, you have pi dn. So this is what you have achieved up till now. So we will equate this part and we'll equate this part to find the value of a property of the spring material, that is K, that is called the spring stiffness. That is called the spring stiffness. Okay, and the units, so this is load upon the displacement x. So I need to get a value or a ratio for W by x. So I'll equate these two parts. So from here I'll get, I can cancel off pi and pi. This 2 will come down, this 2, 4, so you'll get 8 W capital D upon D to the power 4, okay, is equal to, you'll get G into X upon D square N. So from here let me just get the value of W by X. So W upon X is equal to, this is what, this is G into D to the power 4, this 8 into D will come down, so you will have 8 into capital D cube into N. Okay, and from here this is the value for spring stiffness whose units are Newton per meter. So this is the analysis of the closed coiled helical spring under axial load. So the important formulae to note down is this one. Okay, then you need to understand and note down this one. Should also note down this one to get the value for sometimes load or capital D or whatever the property is to be found out. Okay, and you should also note down this part and this part. So this is how you have to analyze this kind of spring. Now let's move on to the next video and look at some basic questions on this topic.